After our plan to take over the world was foiled by the authorities, my cousin and I escaped to The Hague. Tamsin took the day off so that we could go day drinking on the beach and look at some well-posh stuff. Statues along the seashore. They're supposed to represent fairy tales. We figured out some of them, but not others. Got under your skin, howling. You got the white knuckles holding on a tight, keeping your feelings bottled up inside, heading for a collision.
Hi guys, so I'm standing on a very, very windy beach in Den Haag in The Hague. Where I'm currently daytime drinking with my cousin Tamsin. We've come down to the beach bars and I couldn't resist going to have a look at the sea because we don't have any sea in Rwanda. We're a landlocked country, so it's often many years in between me going to stand in the ocean, and it is absolutely freezing cold at the moment, but I couldn't resist taking off my shoes and just wading into the water. It's just, it's really amazing just to be standing here, on a Tuesday, because Tamsin's taken the day off to come and kind of spend with, I can't see a thing, I can't talk. So yeah, Tamsin's taken the day off work and we're here just chilling out, drinking beer, paddling in the sea, and it's so nice. This is really the very first day of my proper road trip, my proper holiday. I loved being back in the UK, but the UK is somewhere that I know very, very well. And it was great to see my family. But also really this road trip was just about going and doing different things, seeing different things. And so that's what I'm doing now. So yeah, this is the first day of my holiday. Tomorrow I'm probably just going to chill out, maybe do some editing, maybe go to a museum, and then it's on to Brussels to see Harris and Rob. So cool.
What I really like in Europe are these hire mopeds. You can locate them using an app and hire one out to drive around the city. Another thing I had to do whilst I was here was satisfy my oily fish addiction with some fresh herring, which is very traditional and very good in the Netherlands.
Hey, it's Makalik.
Then it was on to the local supermarket to find something for dinner. Most of my time in Europe is spent staring at supermarket shelves in wonder. There's just so much available everywhere you look. It's really quite incredible, and often very hard to know what to get when you're not used to having so much choice. One Tesco's in the UK or a supermarket in The Hague stocks more than Simba and Sawa City combined. It can be pretty daunting. These for dessert. You've got to document everything weird that you ever eat.